We are discussing about the GATE solutions for 2008 ECE paper. The topic we are discussing is electron devices. This is fourth question in the series of 2-mark questions. Silicon is doped with boron to a concentration of 4 into 10 power 17 atoms per centimeter cube. Assuming that the intrinsic carrier concentration of silicon is 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube and the value of kT by Q to be 25 millivolts at room temperature, then compared to undoped silicon, the Fermi level of doped silicon A goes down by 0.13 electron volts, B goes up by 0.13 electron volts, C goes down by 0.427 electron volts, D goes up by 0.427 electron volts. Silicon is doped with boron so that it is turning towards p-type semiconductor and the acceptor concentration is given as 4 into 10 power 17 atoms per centimeter cube and intrinsic carrier concentration of silicon given as 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube. Thermal voltage is given as 25 millivolts at room temperature. You need to calculate the Fermi level position with respect to undoped silicon, whether it is goes down by 0.13 volts, goes up by 0.13 volts, or goes down by 0.427 volts, goes up by 0.427 volts. The correct answer for this question is C, goes down by 0.427 electron volts. The Fermi level of doped silicon is goes down by 0.427 electron volts compared to undoped silicon Fermi level. We will see the details now. Given that one p-type silicon, because the semiconductor is doped with boron so that the semiconductor is turning towards p-type semiconductor, given that one acceptor concentration as 4 into 10 power 17 atoms per centimeter cube. And intrinsic carrier concentration of silicon is given as 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube. Threshold thermal voltage is given as 25 millivolts at room temperature. This is the energy band diagram of p-type semiconductor. Energy band diagram of p-type semiconductor. Energy band diagram consisting of valence band, conduction band and energy gap. Energy gap is nothing but difference between lowest energy level of conduction band minus highest energy level of valence band, that is ECP minus EVP. This is energy gap and this dotted line shows that one intrinsic Fermi level. For intrinsic semiconductor, Fermi level lies between the between middle of valence band and conduction band. So this dotted line is going to be in the middle of energy gap, so that it is intrinsic Fermi level. And Fermi level of p-type semiconductor is moves down towards valence band to indicate more number of holes are available in valence band than free electrons in conduction band. Whereas for intrinsic Fermi level, the Fermi level is in the middle to indicate number of free electrons in conduction band is same as number of holes in valence band. So the relation between EFI and EFP we are going to calculate. EFI is nothing but it is related to intrinsic carrier concentration. EFP is related to acceptor concentration. The relation between EFI and EFP can be expressed like this. EFI minus EFP is equal to KT natural logarithm of NA by NI. And KT is given as 0.025. And natural logarithm of NA is 4 into 10 power 17, NI 1.5 into 10 power 10. So after calculation, you are getting it as EFI minus EFP is equal to 0.427 volts. That is, Fermi level of p-type is lesser by 0.427 volts compared to intrinsic Fermi level. So the Fermi level of doped silicon goes down by 0.427 electron volts when compared to undoped silicon. So the correct answer for the question is C. Fermi level of p-type semiconductor goes down by 0.427 electron volts compared to undoped silicon.